So Dad, there's a trending issue today about Balay Dako, a very popular restaurant in Tagaytay where a lot of high-end elites go. And now, this person or netizen who's complaining says they got discriminated upon because they brought in a pet that's an Aspin. An Aspin is Asong Pinoy or what they used to call Asong Kalye in the past. So now, her story goes as, we've eaten at Balay Dako before and we got turned away from Balay Dako today for what I can only guess is because Yoda is an Aspin. Yoda is the name of the dog. We've eaten at Balay Dako before. We know it's pet-friendly. Yoda has in fact been here before as well, so we went there assuming everything's okay. We get to the front of the house and she hands me a paper with pet guidelines. It basically says small, medium dogs only and big dogs are not allowed. It also says that dogs must be in a diaper, can't be smelly, etc., and they will be turned away. I see diaper and instantly think, oh no, we didn't bring that diaper. So Mon asks the front of the house and she says it's okay, there are diapers we can buy inside. She sees Yoda and Ari and nothing is amiss for now. Yoda, Ari, and I are standing in front of the FOH, waiting to be seated and waiting for Mon to come out with the diapers when someone in black staff sees Yoda, goes inside, goes back out, and then whispers something to the front of the house. Suddenly, FOH tells me that Yoda isn't allowed inside. I ask why. She says, up to medium-sized dogs only. And I said, huh? At this point, we've been standing in front of the door for over 10 minutes now. People going in and out, greeting Yoda and Ari, and she didn't say anything to me. Tapos biglang she says, ah, bawal na yung isang dog. So I say, she's medium-sized. We've been here before and no issues naman. And then she said, ano pong breed niya? I have a weird gut feeling immediately, so instead of Aspin, I say mixed breed. I've dealt with this before, I know this, and as annoying as it is, mixed breed is more palatable to elitist establishments like Balay Dako, apparently. Then I ask, what's the size qualifications of medium dogs? Because technically, she is medium-sized, so I always want to know the fine print. Baka naman their medium is different from mine. Instead of answering, they ask me what's her weight. My mistake is that I said 18 kilograms, instead of reiterating my question. After I ask again, ano yung size qualifications na medium dog? And then after they talk amongst themselves, someone comes out and then says 10 to 15 kilograms lang po. At this point, I know 15 kilograms is arbitrary and they just chose a number smaller than Yoda because you can tell when the people are lying to you and they were 100% pulling that out of nowhere. One comes out with the diapers and I ask her to get a refund for the diapers they told us to buy because they won't let Yoda in anyway. We take the dogs back to the car, but this whole situation doesn't sit well with me. I check the website and I can't find anything about 15 kilograms, so I know it's bull. I go back down to the FOH and I ask them to show me where online it says medium dogs only up to 15 kilograms or any of the fine print that specifies only up to 15 kilograms only because it's nowhere on their site, nowhere on their social media. And they say online, but I ask them, show me, because if they show me, okay, gee, we'll find somewhere else to eat, diba? But they can't and just say management said so. And so I say, okay, can I speak with your manager? The manager comes out, takes me to the side, and I ask her, can you show me where it says online or in social media na up to 15 kilograms only? She says sa FB lang po. So I say, okay, show me. And guess what? She can't. She scrolls all the way back to 2023, and she can show me all she can show me are photos of dogs that are allowed. And guess what? A golden retriever bigger than Yoda is in the photo. She makes the freaking mistake of telling me na the only dogs allowed are Shih Tzus, Labradors, and she's trying to show me this picture as proof, right? Na these are all the dogs they allow. Tumangginting na yung tenga ko sa Labrador kasi mas malaki sila kay Yoda. Labradors are easily 25 kilograms and above. And I said, Labrador? Eh, mas malaki sila sa aso ko eh. So ano yung problema? Kasi Aspin siya. And of course, she says no. She tries to explain na someone brought their dogs, may nakagat na. And okay, that's not what I'm asking. That's not my dog's fault. It's that owner's fault. So don't say you're pet friendly and let Labradors in, but not my Aspin. I'm asking where it is in the website that says 15 kilograms only. And there's none. She can't show me because it doesn't exist. So I said, so wala sa website nyo and wala sa social media. And then she tells me, wala po kami po nagsasabi. They decide, sila daw yung nagsasabi, on the day off. Hello, I ask, paano yung mga galing Manila? Paano yung mga bumiyahe para kumain lang dito assuming na pet friendly? Hindi naman kami nakatira dito, kaya dapat nasa FAQ or fine print yun. Don't say you're pet friendly when you're not. I know 15 kilograms is bull. I'm just trying to catch them with a lie and trying to get them to show me proof that this is on their website and social media or not. So what's clear to me is that they decide. They'll decide based on what your dog looks like and they'll let you know just like that. Kasi 15 kilograms talaga, bakit pwede Labrador? Bakit may golden retriever dun sa photo na pinakita nyo of dogs that are allowed? Okay lang naman kung online, there has to be clear guidelines, but don't look at my dog. Ask her what breed is, and then tell me there's a 15 kg rule, and then say that dogs we allow are Shih Tzus and Labradors. Labradors are literally 20 kilograms and above. I'm sure they said more breeds, pero wala na akong nadinig. So, yun, ang story ng nagko-complain na tao. So, right now, what the question is, can an establishment just deny you based on their arbitrary rule that they can, you know, just think of on the spot and just deny you from coming in, like a restaurant?
Well, normally, a restaurant is considered a public place, no? Unless it's by invitation only. Then if it's a public place, normally there are rules and procedures when it comes to discrimination, especially against another person, no? But in this particular case, this is a little bit different because what is being discussed or what is being disallowed is the entry of a pet, no? So there are really no clear guidelines as far as that's concerned. In the United States, in the U.S., they have laws against discriminating against a particular person. No? Mm-hmm. But again, even that is not really totally applicable in all states. So there are some states that will respect that, and there are some states that would not have any guidelines with respect to that. No? Mm-hmm. So this is really a very unique case. No? However, let's look at this situation carefully. No? Because even the owners of the pet are saying that they guess, no? So it's a guess. So they don't really know the intentions or the reason behind the denial, no? So maybe the people inside the restaurant or the managing the restaurant are just being polite because they saw something that they feel like it's not really good for their establishment, no? So it's their prerogative to say no to the entry of a pet, even if they say it's pet friendly, if they see that the pet is going to be harmful to others, no, that's their management prerogative. However, if they refuse the person as a person, then of course that's another story. No, the person can file a complaint with the Department of Trade Industry for discriminatory practices, etc. No, so but again, as I said, this is going to be very difficult in terms of legal proceedings, no, so because again, there's no definite and clear guidelines as far as this is concerned. Nevertheless, if I were the pet owner, what I could have done is maybe, you know, tied the pet outside or leave it in my car, and then continue have my sumptuous lunch or dinner in the said place. If that's the real purpose that I went there, no. Of course, the good thing here or the bad thing here, let's look at both sides, no. The bad thing is, of course, the restaurant now is getting a lot of flack and a lot of bad publicity, that it's like a discriminatory place, and so some people might avoid it. On the other hand, it might be attractive to the elitists, no, to people who have the means and who are in the upper strata of society, because they would feel that the place is really exclusive to people who are more unique or more exclusive, no? So this is the plus and minus of this issue. But on the overall, of course, it's not good for any establishment to make a customer feel bad, no? They could have said it directly that, ma'am, pwede ba pakiiwan na lang yung aso nyo muna sa kotse nyo kasi baka tingin namin hindi makakasamayan sa mga ibang client namin dito sa restaurant. I would say a gentle and polite conversation could have happened so that they could still pursue their meal, no, without having to make the issue a lot more complicated, no? So this is the pros and cons of what happened, because this is really unique. Against people, anti-discrimination or being discriminating against people, there could be cases that could be filed against that because there's civil code to that effect. But when it comes to pets, that's another story altogether, no? Because there are really no clear guidelines as far as that's concerned. I think it's really the management prerogative to disallow pets if they want to.
So the lesson here is basically, if someone discriminates you, like a restaurant or an establishment, based on your physical outlook, like if you as a person, they discriminated you, then that's basically illegal, right, Dad?
Well, technically, yes, no? But again, that can be challenged in court, no? If there will be hearings or proceedings towards that, no? Maybe you can complain with the Department of Trade Industry first, no? Before you go to a judicial body. But at the end of the day, as I said, it's really very challenging to pursue such a case, no? Not only it's taxing, it's expensive. So if I were the person, I would rather avoid that place. I mean, say there are so many other restaurants anyway that you could choose from. So why insist on a place that's not going to be customer friendly as far as you're concerned? On the other hand, if you're the restaurant owner, it's also bad publicity for you if you're refusing clients, no matter who they are, no? Because if you do that, That means to say you're not really customer oriented, no? So as an establishment like a restaurant, they should be very, very hospitable, and they should be very welcoming, and they should handle it properly and how to manage such incidences or such clients.
Yeah, but with regards to pets, there's no clear-cut rules on discrimination because it only applies to humans. So in this case, there's really only moral suasion that can be done by the customer, right?
Yes, yes. It could have been a gentle discussion between the parties that, you know, if my pet is not acceptable, maybe I can just leave it in the car or tie it outside, and then we can still continue our meal, and everything would have been fine, you know. But I guess both parties got carried away with their sentiments. So this is the issue that's prevailing right now. And the sad thing here is, of course, it's getting a lot of bad publicity, and it's not really getting to be a good discussion, you know, in the societies or in the community.
So those are the lessons to learn for today. I'm Engineer Morgan Say, your coach ng Bayan.
I'm Michael Say, your dad ng Bayan.